So I want to talk about retirement. I want to talk about how important it is to really think about that later on. My mom is 77 years old. I'm in that sandwich generation to where I'm basically helping my mom and helping my kids. I'm in that middle. So my mom is coming to move with me, and then I have my kids going off to college and in their own life, and it's a lot. And when I think about retirement, then I think about my husband, who is about to retire in a couple months. So I want to help you with something. There are a lot of households that have high income but are asset poor. And when I say asset poor, I mean that they don't have the amount of money, if something did happen, to cover the basics for at least 3 months. And that's real talk, okay? So when you think about covering the basics of 3 months and high income is anyone that's making, you know, I would say $80,000 and up. But when we talk about, there are so many people that make $100,000 and up, six figures, but really don't have that 3 months reserve. When I say 3 months, to cover the basics, meaning to actually cover their mortgage or their rent, their utilities, their food, and just basic essentials such as, you know, clothing that is more of a need more than a want, right? So let's say that that basic is $4,000 a month. So if you take that $4,000 and you times that by three, that's $12,000. A lot of people that have the high producing incomes do not have $12,000 a month set aside in an emergency for those needs, okay? So I really wanna really discuss, we really need to be thinking about setting our future up, because that is so important. So I like to research. That's what I do. I research, because the more you research, the more you read, the more you learn, and the more you know, and you can grow. That sounds like a rhyme, but it's true. So I was just researching, and I found something from New Hampshire Public Radio. So basically, when I'm talking about asset poor, they were basically from New Hampshire Radio was saying that liquid asset poverty, when you don't have those liquid assets, those basic needs, as far as liquid, when we say liquid assets, you can just go and reach it and you'll have it. And so, you know, when you don't have that, when I talk about retirement, basically what they're saying is your 401k, having a retirement account, or even an annuity account, right? Some type of retirement that you can set up and you can collect it. A lot of people don't have that. So even when I think about business, right? And I'm talking to myself and all the business owners. If you are a business owner, there needs to be some type of simple IRA, something that's set up, because as a business owner, you can actually have that as a write-off, but you can put up an additional $12,500 when we're talking about investments. A lot of times how people get rich, it's not just real estate. Real estate is great. Real estate is the best, but it's really taking that money that you have and having a plan with that money down the line. So when New Hampshire Public Radio was talking about having a 401 account or having some type of retirement and annuity, you know, that set aside, that's the savings that is liquid and you can later get to that. And it's important because a lot of people get pension and setting money aside completely mixed up. So, and I'm saying this because my husband is about to come into a pension, right? But when you come into a pension, that's anybody that is living off a lesser amount than what you make, right? But when you retire, really, all those years of retirement, let's say 25 years of retirement, right? When you retire, really your main bills, like if you have a home, should be paid. If it's not, then now you're back doing the same thing as the hamster on the wheel when you really don't have something else. When I say something else, meaning an IRA set up. So a pension is not just enough. This is not enough. You need a pension. You need an IRA. You need, you know, if you have a business on the side, you need to set up a simple IRA. It has to be something that is more. Come on, y'all. We have to plan. Retirement is real. Pension is real. If you have a, if you are have your own business, you need to have your own IRA set up. I just got finished kicking myself in the head yesterday. If I can, if my feet could reach my head, I was so upset because I did set up a simple IRA, but because of my mind could not switch me to write that check, I couldn't do it, and I missed out of 2 years because I started this in 2018 when I really started getting the finances and everything. I wrote it out. I signed off. I have an account, but never put nothing in it. That's stupid. Like, that's stupid as hell, right? It's stupid. And I'm like, you know what? I need to talk about this. Seriously. And I need to do this. Well, that's already done. But retirement is important. And Chris Hogan, he's a part of Dave Ramsey. He always say retirement is not an age, it's a number, and that is so true. It is a number. You can retire at 35. It is about what did you do when you was 22, when you started working? Did you start plugging that money in, your 401k? Did you start an IRA? It's not too late. If y'all got pensions, great. I hope you do have a pension. Unlike me, because I'm an entrepreneur and I'm not set with a business that has a 401k for me, I have to set those things up, which is a simple IRA. What's the good thing about it is I can go and that's a tax deduction. You know, so that's just something else to talk about later. But I really want to educate you on retirement is real. People, we are household completely high income producing household, but are completely asset poor. No money, don't have any reserves, don't have anything for retirement, you know, but we're shopping, we're going on vacations, we're spending the money on our kids. Then when our kids get an age and they go to college, we don't have no money for our kids for college because we didn't plan that. And that's why it is really good to make sure that you have a financial advisor, that you're planning these things out. Because even the plans that we have in our household personally, they need to be planned out. Like, you can touch your liquid assets and set it up that, you know how you can get penalized? You can touch it to where you can put money up that's liquid for 5 years down the road. So if you plan on purchasing a home, you know, or plan on, you know, having money for your kids' college or helping them with a wedding or whatever it is, you can plan to put that money up in an account for that to grow, not just a savings account. We're talking an account that is producing money. So it is so much that, you know, we're just not educated about, but we're educated on what social media tells us, you know, about, you know, the brand shoes and all the different, you know, we all like the good, the brand things and all those, you know, goody things, but we have to be able to also be serious and really think about our future. You know what? Let me ask you this question. 10 years out, what are you doing? 10 years out, what is your plan? Did you write down your weekly goals? Did you write down your daily goals? Did you write down your goals for 5 years? Do you have a goal? And that's what's important, y'all. And that is so important. So I just wanted to leave you with, you know, when you talk about having that money and you making the six figures, God bless you. But also make sure that you have the reserves. With the reserves, also make sure that you have some type of setup, some, you know, income that's set up. When you talk about purchasing a home, make sure that you have 20% down. I'm telling you, this is my world right now, 20% down. Not only do you have that 20%, that's a lot of money. You need to have 6 months on reserves so you don't be house poor. Things happen. That's really working towards doing things the right way. And this world is about producing money. But if you make $100,000 or more a year, how much of that are you living off of for a year? Do you know how much it takes for you to live off in a year? So if that's $100,000, I hope you don't have a car that's $65,000. So it's all about just making decisions, making plans, and making sure that you are not household poor. All right, y'all. I will check you out later. See you soon.